Here we're going to look at how to calculate bubble and dew pressures and bubble and dew temperatures. When we have a non-ideal solution, so I presented a pressure mole fraction diagram that can be modeled by the modified Raoult's law, which is the mole fraction of component 1 in the liquid phase times the activity coefficient times the saturation pressure. Component 1 equals mole fraction, component 1 times pressure, the total pressure. And then we have an equivalent equation for component 2. So the first thing we're interested in is the bubble pressure. So this means if I have a liquid discomposition and I start lowering the pressure, where's the point where we have the first bubble of vapor? What is the value of this pressure? This blue line corresponds to bubble pressure, and that pressure is just the sum of the partial pressure, so y1p plus y2p equals total pressure. So if I add the right sides of these two equations, I get the pressure, so that's equivalent to adding the left sides. And so when we want to calculate the bubble pressure, we're at one fixed temperature for this diagram. So if I know the temperature and I have an Antoine's equation, I can determine the saturation pressures. I know these because I'm looking at the bubble pressure for a given liquid composition. And then we have to have some idea of how non-ideal this solution is, which means we need some equation that represents the non-ideal behavior, often an empirical equation, so we can get the activity coefficients if we can calculate the bubble pressure. Let's look at the same thing for the dew pressure, which is the green line. So the idea here is we have a vapor, and if we start increasing the pressure, at some point we get that first drop of liquid, that's the dew, and so the dew pressure, we don't know x1 and x2, we know y1 and y2. x1 plus x2 equals 1, however, we know that, and I can solve the modified Raoult's law equation for x1. y1 times pressure over gamma 1 times p1 sat, and I can write the same thing for x2, gamma 2, p2 sat, and so they have to add to 1 at the dew point, the dew pressure, and so since I know the temperature, I know the psats, if I know gammas, and of course, to know gammas, I need to know the x values. To know the x values, I need to know the pressure, so I'm going to have to solve those equations simultaneously. Just by rearranging this equation, I can write an equation for the dew pressure, and it's just 1 over y1 gamma 1 p1 sat plus y2 over gamma 2 p2 sat. Well, now we want to look at the equivalent on a temperature mole fraction diagram for the bubble temperature and the dew temperatures. Let's look at one of those diagrams. So here we have a temperature mole fraction diagram. We fix the pressure, and then if we want to, let's first look at the bubble temperature. The idea is we have a liquid and some composition. As we raise the temperature, we'll get to the point where the first bubble of vapor, and this would be its composition. So the bubble temperature is on this blue line, and the equations are the same, that the bubble temperature is x1 gamma 1 p1 sat. However, now what's different is this is known, and we know x1 and x2 and gamma 1 and gamma 2, but we don't know the saturation pressures because we don't know the temperature. And that's what we're solving for. If we assume that the gammas are independent of the temperature, then it's just a calculation where what's the correct temperature. Essentially, I can substitute for this in Antoine's equation and this one. They both have temperature. I can then solve for the temperature, just nonlinear equation. If the gammas are a function of temperature, then I have to solve simultaneously. Equation allows us to determine gammas also. So that's the bubble temperature, and then the dew temperature. Same equation we had before. In this case, how we know the pressure, we know Y1, we know Y2. We don't know the gammas because we don't know the X values. And gammas definitely depend on the X values. And we don't know the saturation pressures because we don't know the temperature. And so now we're going to have to solve equations simultaneously. Antoine's equations for the two pressures, this equation, and then the equation that relates gammas to mole fractions. So the dew temperature calculation is a lot more complicated than the dew pressure calculation. But we're using the same modified Raoult's law to calculate the values and using Antoine's equations.